That's a cool title, Screen. Hello everyone, this is Catcomb1 and I will be starting a playtest here for another Wad in Progress by Cheese Wheel by the simple three-letter name of CPD for the moment, and episode 2 consisting of maps 12 through 20 was just released this weekend, and he expressed interest in playtesting, which I always enjoy doing, so I'll give a shout to Cheese Wheel for the interest, because I always appreciate authors interested in me playing or testing their wads, and because some videos and feedback have already been given over the past couple of months for the first 11 levels, and because I go blind from a pistol stout anyways, I figured I'm going to stout from map 12, I Live Again. Yeah, I get the reference, also Blood E1M1 here. And if you didn't make it out, I did have to take a look. Map 11 is a death exit. So, we start the second episode fresh, whether playing Pistol Stout or Continuous. And I do plan, time permitting, on going back to the first episode if I finish the second episode and still have time to do more videos. And if you'd like to see the first episode come first, then just let me know in the comment, please, because I will happily just scout for map 1 in that case. But for now, I figured I'll scout for map 12 here, where there's been less videos and feedback already. So this is Catcomb 1, let's get going. What did we do in Blood E1M1, the ceiling grows from up top of us? Well, that can't happen in the Doom level, so instead a coffin rises. And I guess we also had the death exit because we're berserk, we're fisting here. Yep, I wonder if this is going to be a melee map. Often map 21 is a melee map, but otherwise known as Berserk map. But in this particular Megawad, the Hell episode begins on map 12 and not map 21, so it would be fitting enough to have map 12 be the Berserk map. Okay, it's not a Berserk map for very long. And it didn't take very long to kill me because of those shotgunners that I didn't have a weapon for yet. Actually, we have some shotgun shells on the floor here, but I need to own my shotgun. So yeah, I'm calling this E2M1, with also map 12. Okay, this music, is it? You got another thing coming. You got another thing coming. I think I just recognized that potentially. Don't know who made that, I just recognized the tune. Okay, I am... Yet, for the second time, I failed to get my shotgun and get rid of those shotgun those in time. You got another thing coming. You got another thing coming. Okay. I need my shotgun, and I need to get rid of these shotgunners before they peck me too much. Maybe it's just inspired by the song I was thinking of. I don't know. Well, we definitely got Tell here. And more like Ultimate Dude, more like Doom 1 Hell than Doom 2 Hell. Even though there are some Doom 2 textures mixed in. Also very little health here. I remember some people complaining about the early level saying that health is a bit stingy. Seems that's gonna still be our case here. Thankfully it's not a pet peeve of mine. Any feedback that's been given so far from Map 12 Ambers, I haven't read anything about whatsoever, so I'm not the least bit biased. And all I really know about the first 11 levels is that the feedback was generally positive. This also looks like very nearly a first wad from the ortho. I say very nearly because he made a couple of 200 minute speed maps for VR in 2014, which, if I recall, I found to be highlights in that particular set. But in the between 2015 and 2019, I can't find anything at all. Debbie sounds to me like you got another thing coming. How to say for sure with a MIDI, which is actually a good thing, because if it sounds too much like the actual song, sometimes YouTube will copyright on me. Man, I wish I could have saved the Berserk for help. Maybe the fact that I haven't seen a single stim pack or med kit yet argues that health could be just a tiny bit scarce even for me. But I'll usually be one of the last ones to complain about health. You got a good classic look to these maps that isn't over-detailed and is never gonna have stuff that, well, the architecture gets in the way of the gameplay, and yet everything is serviceable. I don't think these levels were made with any specific time, sector, or line depth limitation, but none of them are huge. Only maps 11 and 20 so far exceed 200 monsters. Thanks for not making them hit scan. That was on me. If I kill all these imps, I'm gonna run out of shotgun ammo pretty close to it. So I'll just go grab the blue key and get to the conveniently placed blue door where I can pick up my chain gun. So far, aside from some Doom 2 textures, this could just as easily be an Inferno replacement for Ultimate Doom. Which I enjoy all. Well, as soon as I said that, we've got some chain gunners in the mix. And a single medkit. I don't mind Doom 1 Master-centric stuff, though. Looks like we will be getting all three keys here, despite it not being too big of a level. Anything this level reminds me more of the PSX Hellkeep than the PC Hellkeep. Just thinking about E3M1 both hell levels. Certainly does not remind me of Nirvana. Okay, seems I'm gonna have to run past you to get enough ammo. Okay, now we're getting into the Doom 2 stuff and reminding ourselves that this is a Doom 2 map set. Okay. Now I'm starting to think the health balance is a little better and a bit more my thing, so I'd probably add at least one med kit to the area getting towards the blue key that isn't already there, unless it's intended to be a health starvation situation. Okay, all those calcans, all those tombs. The amber we need to be going. Yep, that'll grab me the get to see the blue key, to get to see the yellow key well before I get it, not the blue key. And get to nicely connect to where I saw it from. Oh, okay, yep, the yellow key is just the exit door. Okay, so I guess you just open the exit and it just walks straight to the outside. Well, that was a fun level. Pretty easy to please with this type of classic stuff. I didn't get any secrets, but I nonetheless, even outside of secrets, think my feedback would be to not be quite so starved of health in the area that doesn't need any keys to access. Other than that, I can't really think of anything, so let's go on to map 13, Red Keep. Not Hell Keep, Red Keep. As I said, I am resetting to a pistol stout each level. That's my typical style. Pretty loud jelly outside the keep, P.O. You got another thing coming and getting. Yeah, for whatever reason, the map 12 meaty put that in my head. I don't need to be super focused on picking off every single imp and these red rocks. Which I found out just about a month ago that this texture is literally named Red Rock. this one, not this one. Is misaligned, Tio. I don't know if that's an important deal in this ward. Okay, blood is not damaging. Okay, you're not gonna just fight the Keiko demons easily for me, are you? Well, I guess I don't. I can kind of just get on with the level progression if I want to. Head out inside the keep, which makes all those shotgunners pretty much not be a threat. I might try and get the combat in this area to be a little bit less incidental. Like, make you engage some kind of fight with those Keiko demons and shotgunners. I don't know, I might end up in an area later where I get exposed to the fire if I didn't kill them now. I'll find out. Okay, these textures are misaligned here. Don't know if alignment's really a priority, but I'll point it out. This is actually the second time in 2020 I've seen a new or almost new ortho just come out with a what seems to be quite a solid classic playing map set. Earlier on in the year we had Universal Quantifier Devil's Grip, which I'd never heard of Universal Quantifier before this year. Didn't exactly think that backpack was a secret. It was pretty clear I could just hop to the rock. But maybe just an easy to find secret, a gimme you so call it. Well, I knew trying to rush those chain gunners, if I didn't kill two of them in that blast, I was gonna die. I should have ducked out to the right. I was worried there'd be more hit scanners here. At this point, I still think the combat with the outside area would be a little bit too much incidental. I mean, I'm not saying lock the player into every fight and make sure they kill every monster, but certainly make sure the ones they don't kill remain annoying, to say the least. At least the dangerous ones. Would see, like, over here, I could have left everyone alive outside and they would be of no consequence at all. I sort of like the blue torches around the blue doors. Is that the rocket launcher? I thought I saw another one. Well, maybe I saw the rocket launcher when I was outside off in the distance. Now here I suddenly have some chance of getting picked off if there were monsters still left outside. I could definitely feel being penalized here if I... Oh, thanks for hitting the lost soul. I'd have taken, gotten rid of those Keiko demons and maybe the shotgunners. I don't know if they'd have had a good line of sight on me or not. Blue skull to get back to the blue doll. Yep, lift isn't entirely safe. There's a fireplace hidden behind it, and it's occupied. Leads me to one of the blue doors I saw previously, which leads me right to the other blue door I saw previously, which leads me to a teleport. Whoa! That was an in-your-face, Del! Not entirely fair if I didn't have the health to absorb that with. Oh, and the outside area's behind me again. So there is some interaction with the rest of the level in the outside area that could penalize you if you hadn't cleared it. Okay, that misalignment signaling a secret or monster closet later, I'm guessing. Well, I know the trap's coming. I still don't have the health to necessarily do it without dying. Well, if I can take care of the chain gunners that quickly, I'd probably do. Don't know if you meant to have me see it coming or not, or at least have an observant player see it coming. If you didn't, then the textures should be aligned to fit better. Okay, we forgot our first wide open. Looks like it's gonna be a decent big fight area here just because of all the rockets and two med kits and ammo. All that given to us because it is gonna be a decent fight with an outvial in the mix. Uh-oh, I can't use rockets here. Need to. Can't get stuck by all the imps if I'm on the rocket launcher. Can infight out a lot of the rest of it if I make my priority be the ouchie. Okay, so yeah, at least the Keikos will probably be annoying me here again in the outside area. The outside area is almost like a central hub sort of ALA the Living End that you walk around. Guess I'm gonna... Should I take the throne? I'm going to experiment with leaving that Baron of Hell behind, and this Mancubus too. Okay, dig. Cheese Wheel does seem to be making sure that the enemies in the outdoor area have plenty of chances to see me if I didn't kill them. Well, I'm gonna guess that's gonna be the ending. Well, I'd say just the textual alignment I found, if that's a concern to you, and I'm sort of in two minds about the outside area. It's definitely very incidental when you're outside, but you do have to be exposed to it several more times in the level. I would say some of the later fights, some of those last couple of fights, maybe make a tinge harder to get away from, but not really much wrong here. Health was fine for me. I would say the beginning of map 12 really stuck out for health starvation, so unless that was the intent, I'd add a kit or two. Well, that's going to be my feedback for now. I'll pick up with map 14, Bad Business, later, which looked to have a hot start. Rocket launch on enemies right away. So if you enjoyed this video or my videos in general, please feel free and welcome to comment. I always appreciate them very much. And I did just notice I do have a lot of excess ammo. Generally though, if health isn't generous, I don't care too much about the ammo balance. So I'll leave it to Cheese Wheel to decide if there's too much ammo or not in this watch shells and bullets mainly. And do feel free to make requests. They can be your wives or other people's. I do take them. There should be a subscribe link in the video in the description, and links to some other playlists I've been working on in the description. So this is Catcomb 1, and I'll be back with more later.